Is it a law that car dealers must pull your credit? Is it possible to buy a car without having them pull credit? The simple answer is yes. Hi, I'm Kevin Hunter, also known as the Homer Guy, and author of Is That the Best You Can Do? This video is brought to you by YouTube's best channel on car buying and selling, courtesy of the Homer Guy team. Another round of super high intensity training is coming up for car buyers. If you like the Homer Guy videos and you want to support some of our swag like this hoodie or sweatshirt, check the merch shelf down below and show your appreciation. Today we're talking about car dealers who try to pull your credit the moment you walk through the door and insist that they must pull credit to sell you a car. There's a lot of diversity in car buyers these days. Some of you don't need financing. Why? Because you are savvy enough to have your own financing lined up through your own bank or credit union, or you're smart with your money and have it saved up to buy the car outright. You guys are awesome and you don't need financing at all. Why would a dealer need to pull your credit? Yet the dealer still insists, right? They say, we have to pull your credit. It's the law. It's our responsibility to make sure that you're not a terrorist or something. We have to know that you are who you say you are. You're thinking, what? Is that even true? The answer to that question is coming up, and at the end, I'll cover how to protect your credit from unscrupulous car dealers. That and more right after this short message from the Homework Guy team.
If you're a first timer on the Homework Guy channel, consider subscribing and leaving us a comment below. Add hashtag the Homework Guy if you'd like a response directly from Kevin or one of the Homework Guy staff members. We're always glad to help our loyal followers, and the best part is, there's no charge. You can also email the team at info@thehomeworkguy.com with a specific question, or if you'd like a free contract review, just black out your personal information and send it to us. We'd love to hear from you. Just be aware that we do get a lot of requests, so just be patient while you wait for a response. Back to you, Kevin.
You're ready to buy a car. You've done your homework. Perhaps you have cash available in your own bank account, or you lined up your own financing. And the first thing the car dealer wants to do when you contact them or arrive at the dealership is to start pulling credit. If you push them off for a bit, they'll bring it up again. If you stand your ground, at some point, the little scoundrels are going to tell you it's the law. Can you buy a car without having a car dealer pull your credit? Yes. If you have your loan already lined up, or if you intend to pay cash for the vehicle, you can definitely buy a car without the dealer pulling your credit. Since that's the case, why do dealers push so hard for you to fill out a credit application? And why will they lie to you about it being law if you refuse? Well, dealers lean on a couple excuses for doing this. One of them is the Patriot Act. What is the Patriot Act and why was it passed into law? The Patriot Act is legislation passed in 2001 to improve the abilities of U.S. law enforcement to deter and detect terrorism. The Act's official title is Uniting and Strengthening America by Providing Appropriate Tools Required to Intercept and Obstruct Terrorism, or USA Patriot. Many people argue that the Patriot Act actually violates the First Amendment by effectively authorizing the FBI to launch investigation of American citizens, in part for exercising their freedom of speech, but that's a whole nother can of worms that we're not going to be touching today. One thing is for certain, the Patriot Act was not passed to help car dealers, and it does not say that a car dealer must pull credit to sell you a car. That is pure nonsense. Let's talk about your rights as a consumer connected to a different piece of legislation. Under the Fair Credit Reporting Act, a car dealer may pull your credit, but only if you consent by filling out and signing a loan application. The FCRA details what data can be collected and who can view a credit report and under what provisions. If you decline to fill out a credit application because you don't need credit from the dealer, there is no law anywhere that states that you must. If you're paying with cash or prearranged financing, the dealer has no right to coerce you to agree to a credit check by invoking the Patriot Act, and they have no right to pull your credit without your consent, as clearly laid out in the Fair Credit Reporting Act. Yet this nonsense still happens, and it happens every day in every city, in every state in America. Unfortunately, car dealers have been notorious abusers of consumer rights when it comes to credit. Now, is there reality that car dealers play a role in checking for terrorists? Well, sure, but it doesn't involve them pulling your credit. Car dealers are simply required to check all car buyers against the list supplied by the U.S. Department of Treasury Office of Foreign Assets Control, otherwise known as OFAC. This list has the name of specifically designated nationals and blocked people who are generally sympathetic or involved with foreign terrorist groups. The Patriot Act just clarifies this requirement, adding auto dealers to the list of businesses that must conduct a check. A dealer must run your name through the OFAC list using specialized software, and they need nothing more than a driver's license to do it. It literally takes 5 to 10 seconds to do it. Forcing you to fill out a credit application, on the other hand, does nothing more than feed their own purposes. So let's talk about the real reason car dealers want to pull your credit, because now you know it's not the law, and it's definitely your right to say no. They have no right to force you to fill out a credit application. Why then do they insist on it? Car dealers and their finance offices act as financing middlemen. They provide loans through banks that they have prearranged deals with. They get a cut on everything they do with these banks. And financing cars is one of the top ways dealers make money. When you walk into the dealership and you have your own cash to pay with, or you have a pre-approved loan you got through your own bank or credit union, the dealer has a profit reason to persuade you to change your mind and apply for a loan with a bank affiliated with the dealership. That's it. That's entirely it. There are dealers and sales staff who follow the rules while trying their best to make a sale. They are the good guys. They'll ask a customer to fill out a credit application, but if the prospective buyer declines, the salesperson just moves on to other means of making the sale more profitable. They have tons of products and fees they can still saddle a car buyer with. We told you about those in two of our popular videos right here on the Homework Guy channel. Shady dealers, however, just ramp up the pressure. If you say no, they get more persistent, and you're likely to hear about the Patriot Act and how they have to make sure you are who you are and that you're not a terrorist, all that blah, blah, blah. Because most people have no idea what the Patriot Act even is, unethical salesmen take advantage of that lack of knowledge and then conduct an illegal credit check. When you give over your driver's license for a test drive, the information on the license is enough for them to run your credit. These kinds of dealers will pull a credit report while you're out for a test drive and then try to undercut the financing you have with your own bank or credit union. Let's recap. No regulations or laws exist that require a car dealer to pull a credit check. If you're not financing a car with them, there's no reason for them to pull your credit. Let me wrap up with this. Because some of you fill out a credit application because you think it's no big deal, here's what you should know when you let a dealer bully you into doing a credit application. Unnecessary credit checks sting your credit score. Credit checks bring down your score and cost you when you apply for future credit. It doesn't matter if it was authorized by you or not. When a dealer pulls your credit, it's called a hard pull or hard inquiry. This can drop your score 5 to 10 points immediately, sometimes more, and it remains on your credit report for about 2 years. The effects can really sting. If you happen to apply for a mortgage over the next 24 months, the bank may tell you that you have auto loan inquiries on your credit report, but no auto loan. Looks like you are a credit risk, and they turned you down for a loan. Doesn't even have to be true. That one ding on your credit report creates an unnecessary cloud of suspicion about whether you were rejected by an auto lender, even if you weren't, and it could prevent you from getting a better interest rate on your mortgage, costing you thousands of dollars in the long run. Wouldn't you just be a little ticked off to find out that happened to you? Here's how you can avoid unnecessary credit checks at car dealers. Number one, know your rights. A dealer does not need to check your credit to sell you a car. Ask any dealer who cites the Patriot Act or any other law to show you the statute in writing. They won't be able to show you anything. If they do go get something, use your phone and just say, "I'm going to record this conversation for my own records." Watch them shut up and disappear mighty quickly. Number two, if you know you won't get a loan through the dealer, make it clear right away that you have the ability to pay for the vehicle, but you're not talking about financing until the very end. Since you know now that it's only bad dealers who force you to fill out a credit application early, you know you should leave when they push it. Number three, if you have a pre-approved car loan from your own bank or credit union, and it was done very recently, you could consider telling the dealer finance officer, "See if you can beat the terms from my own bank." Here's something you should know about FICO software. Since your own bank already pulled your credit recently, and FICO knows that you might check other sources, multiple auto loan inquiries in a short period of time, usually 30 days or so, are bundled and counted as one inquiry. So your own bank's inquiry won't show up any different than an inquiry from the dealership. Number four, check your own credit after visiting dealerships and challenge any unauthorized hard pulls. If any dealer you visited pulled your credit without authorization, file a complaint with your state attorney general's office and then dispute this as an error on your credit report. In order for it to stand up, the reporting agency has to be able to obtain a signed application and authorization from the dealership to prove that you wanted your credit pulled. If you didn't do that, Don't let the unauthorized pool hurt you down the road. As our return viewers know, we've published tons of videos on the Homework Guy channel for you to learn from. Make sure you check out all of these great videos we have here on the channel. We've gone to a lot of work to help you out, so use the resources we put out there for you. All right, if you learned something today and appreciate the video, consider giving us that great big thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Include hashtag the Homework Guy. Share the video on social media with your friends and make sure you join us on Facebook and Twitter too. We post notifications and other updates on our social media sites and answer car buying questions there as well. If you love what we do and want to say thanks for the tip, well, the PayPal and Cash App links you see right here will be easy to find in that description box below. But no problem if you can't do a tip. Don't worry about it. You can say thanks by sharing our video with your family and friends and continuing encouraging others to subscribe to the channel. That is huge. It's one of the most important things you can do as a loyal follower and viewer here on the Homework Guy channel. We appreciate everything you do and help us get the word out to defeat the bad guys in the car business who still haven't learned that fairness and honesty is the best business model. Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you on our next video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter. Until next time, take care everyone.